different way where they have also not done their homework. Yeah. And it is more like, you know, there is this herd mentality thing even happening in this sector where, you know, something succeeds and everybody goes yes. after it without really doing their homework as to what is needed. So, I have come across at least, I would say, about 20 e-commerce players who want to make it big, who have not even seen an Amazon warehouse or been to Bangalore to see how, what is the scale of operations of a Flipkart or an Amazon. But still, when they say, for the fear of, you know, I wouldn't want to typically disappoint these people because they are young, but at some stage, it has to be made clear to them that, you know, go back and you really need to understand more about the, you know, about the sector or the domain in which you plan to make it big. Because without sufficient knowledge that they come up, this is one of the reasons for many startups to fail also. Not understanding the market properly or not understanding competition, you can call it anything, but the fact is they have not done their groundwork properly. So I think that is one of the very key reasons also. So there is suddenly you have a lot of these, you know, and the startup thing itself, you know, became very prominent or popular a few years back. And a lot of these youngsters, when they come, the families are not too sure as to what actually they are doing. Okay, yeah, it's like colloquially speaking, and yeah, startup nartha. So about what about the how does the fund come in? So how much money have they burnt? So all these things. To actually put it together, most of them are typically engineers. Ideas, I'm not saying all are bad, but even the good ideas to kind of, you know, typically, you know, get them fructified is very difficult because tying up funds, how to take it forward, the time frame, competition, you're managing your team. So it's a lot more effort, I would say, as to go in several of these cases.
Adding to that, in my office, every third day, there are a bunch of young guys coming with an email. They have an idea. Some of them actually come, and ask for investment, some actually present there. So literally every third day, there are three youngsters coming out. They have no idea what they're going to do. And some they have the same thing. Some of them have the same idea. And they just keep coming every day. So that's
I'll tell you something very interesting. So this was, I think, about a year back. So, a person working in a startup co-working space comes up with a specific idea saying this is extremely good. So, you know, this is why we are funding. And these guys typically knew what they were doing in the sense like this is what we plan, this is our product, and this is how we plan to take it forward. So, I asked, do you have competition? So, they said, not to our knowledge, not at least in Kerala. And I have to tell them, you have one person, one company in your own campus, which is doing something very similar. So unfortunately, this is also the revenue set. So this just reminded me. So when they said, you know, two or three guys coming probably the same stuff, it could even, you know, be, you know, it could even throw up a situation where in the same space, same building, yeah, there are two different companies trying to develop the same thing.